You're fucking kidding me. What's up, peoples? The Viking Fairy welcoming you back to Nancy Drew and the Sea of Darkness, and you're freaking kidding me. I had to look up three different walkthroughs just so I can find this motherfucker right here. Bitch. Okay, there is nothing left to do in this cabin. God, I hope so.
Check.
Yes, alright. Splurge the Mr. Skip. Whoops. Not what I wanted to do. I swear, Gunner, if you stop me. Thank you. Alright, so... and a lot of things in this guy. What the hell?
Ooh. It's subtle, but I see some differences in the halves of this pattern.
Uh-huh. Find the difference today. Oh. Boom. Okay. Oh, right. Right. Ha! Yay! Oh no. Let's do this thing.
The year was 1783 when Lucky Fissures opened and vomited fire and smoke onto the land. Thousands perished immediately into the madness. And the sky grew dark and even foreign lands were covered. We called those times the Mist Hardships, and in that darkness, the people of Skipbrot struggled to survive. One night, a ship came crashing into harbor. It was the Herrlichkeit. Captain Lawrence and his crew were rescued and taken in.
Hmm.
Once ashore, Lawrence explained that he carried with him a mountain of golden treasure. He promised to share it, along with his ship's food supplies, in exchange for shelter until winter's end. That winter was darker than ever. No stars shone, and soon even the supplies on the Herrlichkeit ran thin. But even in the middle of that hardship, love bloomed, for Lawrence had fallen in love with Alda, the daughter of the town's founding family. Soon, Lawrence and Alda were wed, and soon after that, the marriage bore a baby girl. Eventually, the poison water drew away from the shores, and the fish returned to Skipbrot. Thanks to Lawrence, many more people had survived than the neighboring towns. The townspeople wanted to rebuild their home. They needed money, and fast. They needed the treasure Lawrence had promised them.
Something tells me he doesn't deliver on his promise.
But Lawrence explained that he would need to sail somewhere else in order to retrieve his promised treasure. The townspeople called Lawrence a liar. They accused him of trying to escape with his new wife and child. They grew angrier and angrier. Soon, a fight had broken out. When the dust cleared, the townspeople looked in horror at what they had done. Alda was no longer breathing. The townspeople carried the heavily injured Lawrence into the inn, intending to banish him once he had recovered from his wounds. But he too passed away, leaving only a diary for his young daughter. That daughter eventually grew, married, and bore a daughter of her own, and so on. Today, Elizabeth is the only remaining descendant of the original Captain Lawrence. But the fabled treasure Lawrence spoke of was never found.
Oh, what a sad story.
Yeah, I wish I had done this sooner. Because then it would have actually been a surprise that Elizabeth was the last remaining person. And it would have made sense when she said stuff about things and stuff. And I'm going to buy everything in this shop. Everything I think is cool.
I can't buy anything if Soren's not here.
Oh, what? Sharon's not here. The fuck do you mean Sharon's not here? Let's snoop. Great Volcanic Winter, we already figured that out. Okay. So I really want to get more stuff for for Mr. Nickerson. Oh no. No. Don't tell me. Is there, like, nobody here anymore?
That's the ship alarm. Oh, no.
What's going on? Not here. Where is everyone? What's going on? Okay, y'all, I'm gonna go up to the crow's nest. See if I can find anything. Going on? What's going on? For the love of... Okay, there's nothing I can do. I don't know what it wants me to do.
Well, fire. I bet these images represent pieces of larger words. Maybe if I match them.
Sweet. Yes, I did have to cheat.
Two broken pieces. I bet I can fix the locator now.
Sweet. Okay. Let's go into the captain's quarters and do that pin puzzle, because we obviously... Yeah, I was right. C, E. E. V. F. W. M. S. R. Hang on.
This is one of the sounding numbers Magnus was looking for.
Huh. All right, so 14. Okay, so...
Did that.
Discover the ship's wheel.
Check.
The importance of the thing.
Still have to do that. Check.
Explore the misty
skip. Did that.
Discover the importance of the music box. And the token. Oh, lion token. Isn't the figurehead on the ship a lion? Yes.
I bet I can use Dagny's token to rotate these. Let's get them all facing right side up.
Thank you! Jeebus! Okay.
That's done.
Right, so 14, 26, and 86.
I've got 14 and 26. I'll need to find two more numbers to add up to 86.
14... The Krollmeister.
Oh, got it! These are the four numbers for that lock.
Right, so 11, 14, 26, 35. 11, 14, 26, 35. 11, 14, 26, 35. 11, 14, 26, 35. 11, 14, 26, 35. 11, 14, 26, 35.
Those noises are mechanical. Something within the ship must have unlocked elsewhere.
Ooh, like... that door in their cargo hold?
There's a room back there. It looks like it was concealed in the ship's lining.
Let's go quickly, quickly, quickly.
It looks like I need to press the correct sections according to these numbers.
Numbers appear to show the number of touching sections which have been filled.
It's a machine of sorts, but some pieces are missing. That's done.
Okay. Hey, hey! Whoa.
Well, this looks ancient. It must be from the original captain. I need to get this sliding shape over to that treasure marking.
Oh. Ugh. Okay, good. Boom. Boom. Whoa. Holy crap. No. I need to get over here. Get into the green. Boom. Boom, boom. Ha!
All right, it popped open.
Alright, so that's going to be it for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you're having as much fun as I am. And remember, I'm pulling for you. We're all in this together. I know I'm speeding through this, but I really, 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 really want to get through this. I really want to get through this.